that we should have, amen, stayed away from. Now there are things in the church that the Lord has said no, but we've allowed them because we have looked for popularity rather than scriptural relevance. Yes. Saints of God, we cannot be a church that is popular. We must be a church that is right. Rightly dividing the word of truth. Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And so when I looked at the snare, the Lord said, look at that. There was another snare that was just set up that we're going to run into. So say to God, you got to be willing, amen, to know what you're talking about and to be able to say, yes, God does speak to me. Yes, the Spirit of the Lord is using me. Yes, I believe in Jesus Christ. Yes, I believe that he rose again. Is there a believer in the house that believes in Jesus Christ? Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah, that the trap that is set. When they set the trap, they laid down bait. They laid down something that would entice you. They laid down something. In other words, he didn't just put wire up and expect you to walk where the wire is. Even though the wire was in a place where you couldn't really see it, it wasn't enough to just be set. They had to do what? Had to entice you. Had to tempt you. Had to bring something that looked good from the outside. Now, if the bird understood that the trap was there to kill him, I don't think even the food wouldn't have been worth it. If they understood that the trap was there to kill them, I don't think the berries would have been worth it. I don't think if a rabbit could see that there was a trap involved, that carrot, amen, would not have been worth it. I think if many of us could see the trap that the enemy has for you, I think you realize that that boyfriend wasn't worth it. That lady of your life, amen, is outside the will of God, just one word.
Yes.
That drink that you just have to have, that drug that you can't pull away from, that, amen, that lying tongue where you just got to make up stuff for the reason of insanity just is not worth it. Because I'd rather, amen, be where Jesus is than to be caught in the snare of the enemy. Why? Because the Bible says the wages of sin is death. The Bible tells us that Satan said, I come to kill, steal, and what?
Destroy.
How many know that he's out to destroy everything about you? He's out to destroy. It seems like somebody, let me wake you up real quick. If it seems like somebody's out to mess your family up, I got news for you. There is.
Yes.
It seems like you got somebody working against you on your job. There is.
Yes.
Seems like, amen, somebody's trying to point the finger at you. Anybody been accused of some stuff that you know you didn't do, and you look around, out of all these folk here, why are you going to come and mess with me? Because you got an enemy who's destroying and trying to destroy everything you have. So, thanks to God, what am I telling you? You have an enemy that is fighting against you. Now, your part, you got to be careful, because when I look at the snare was meant so that it would be concealed, the trap would be concealed so that you couldn't see it. But yet, in order to get you to come near it, they had to entice you with something that you like. And how many of you know that you got to be careful, because the enemy will use something that you like in order to get you to places that you shouldn't be, so that they can get you out of the will of God, so that they can trap you in a snare. And I got news for you. If you ever seen an animal caught in a snare, it ain't going to let you go. A snare is meant to entangle you, catch you, some by the feet, some by the neck, depending on where it is. But when it grabs hold of you, amen, you can't get. That's why I'm so glad that the anointing destroys the evil. Some of you better thank God right now real quick for the anointing of God. Some of y'all was caught in the snare of the enemy, but God made a way out of no way so that you can say, I will destroy the yoke of bondage. That's why there's only one thing that can get you out of the snare. It's the blood of Jesus Christ. It is his grace and his mercy. Aren't you glad that when the enemy, because some of y'all know good and well what it feels like to be in a snare, don't you? Oh, y'all talk to me real quick. Some of y'all know exactly what it feels like to be in a snare. You were caught, amen, I knew you were caught. Couldn't get out, couldn't get away. Mama couldn't pull you out. Daddy couldn't pull you out. Amen. Preachers couldn't pull you out. But it took the hand of the Almighty God to reach down himself and to get you out of the snare of the enemy. So you ought to tell the Lord, thank you. I was in the snare of deception. I was in the snare of defeat. I was in the snare, hallelujah, of living in adultery. I was in the snare. Hallelujah, that in Jeremiah 18 and 22, that the digging of a pit to take prey was customary, and the hiding of the snare was for the feet. In other words, the enemy will dig a ditch for you. kept you in a snare and put you in a hole. Anybody ever felt like you was in a hole? The more you try to, and that's why I love to use the example, the more you try to dig your way out, you realize you can't dig your way out of a hole. Amen. You got to try to climb your way out of a hole. But some of us still dig and trying to say, I'm going to get myself out of this financial nightmare. I'm not going to pay tithes and offering, but guess what? That's what I'm telling you. I got debt, and instead of me paying tithes and offering, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go, thank you, Holy Ghost. I'm going to go here, and I'm going to try to give a little bit extra and get myself out of this debt so that after I'm finished, I can give to the church like I ought to. And God said, all you're doing is taking a ditch and doing what? Digging yourself deeper and deeper. And God said, what you need to say, you know what? I got myself in this mess, and I can't get myself out of this mess. Amen. I know people tell you what you got yourself into, you got to get yourself out of. But I'm so far, I'm so deep down in this financial mess that I can't get myself out. I got to have some supernatural help to get me out of here. So what I'm going to do, I know I got debt, and I got issues, I know I got money problems, but I'm going to give the tenth like the Lord told me to. I'm going to give my offering. I'm going to trust God and be disciplined. Do the right thing. And when I need it the most, God's going to make a way out of no way. I wish I had one witness that will give a testimony that will say God will open up a door that doesn't even make sense. I feel the anointing in this place. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hosea 9 and 8 talks about, hallelujah, I have, amen, a foul snare and done all his ways. Jeremiah 50 says, I have laid a snare for thee. Amos 3 and 5, hallelujah, indicate that the snare was set for the feet to entangle. Luke 21 and 34, but take heed to yourselves, lest haply that day come on you suddenly as a snare. Romans 11, 9, let their table be made a snare and a trap. What am I saying? I want to just give you an indication that the Bible talks about snares in the Old Testament and the New Testament over and over again, letting you understand that there is an enemy that is laying a trap for you, and a trap is not made just so you can get away. A trap was made to keep you until you were destroyed, killed, or set what? Set on fire, whatever it is, the enemy has laid traps for you. So I want you to wake up and understand that the trap is out there, so it's time for you to stop falling for the same old. Yes. How many of y'all ever got out of trap, walk right back to where it was? How many people know that because we are sheep, that's what we do? Amen. A sheep will be lost. Amen. It will be set a trap for the sheep. And guess what? You'll get the sheep out of the trap. Guess what the sheep will do tomorrow? Y'all talk to me this place. The sheep will go right back to the same trap that they were delivered from. That's why the Bible lets us know that we are the sheep of his pasture. In other words, God just delivered you out of that relationship, and you ain't got no better sense than to go right back in. And you say, but this time, amen, anybody made a statement, I'm going to try to him, but this time I'm going to try for Jesus. This time I'm going to pray for that man. This is what I did last time. I didn't fast and pray for him. No, what you did last time, you got caught up in the trap that Jesus delivered you out of, and now you about to take yourself right back into the trap. So the same trap that destroyed you last time is getting ready to mess you up all over again. Because unless the Lord told you to go back, let me tell you something. If the Lord has that for you to go back to, he will already work it out on that end, and he will let you know now is time. Amen. He didn't say go back to the same trap he got you out of. You bought a car last time, got yourself in financial debt. Why are you going to go and buy another car more expensive and you still can't afford it, and you got a 25%, amen, interest rate, trying to figure out, and you say, God, said it again. Y'all quiet. That's good. That's all right. Maybe y'all want a little teaching. You go out and get yourself a car. Say, boy, I got the car that I wanted. Amen. I got an 8-year plan to pay it off at 25% interest. You done paid $100,000 for a $20,000 car. And you say, God bless me. And you get him a church. God bless me with a new car. No, the Bible says when God adds the blessing, he doesn't add the burden. So I want to know, was it God or was it you? Look at the neighbor and say, you fell for the same trap. You fell for the same trap. You got out of one relationship and her name was Maria, and you went to the next one, her name was Mary. You did the same thing over again, just a different player, a different game, but the same product. You left one job when you were driving trucks, now you're driving buses. You left the same thing and went to, amen, their cousin. What did the Lord say? When I deliver you out of the snare of the enemy, I have no desire for you to go back and play around, because that trap was designed to kill you. Look at your neighbor and say, the trap was designed to kill you. It, the devil is not playing with y'all. I know we might be playing around with him, but he's not playing with you. It was designed to kill you. So God said, now I got you out of it. Don't you just so readily go back into it, because sometimes we think in our minds, God says, that sometimes we think these down, and I want you to watch yourself so you stop falling over the same thing. Because again, not only is it meant for you not to see it, how do you know a lot of times I can see everybody else, but I can't see myself? Yeah. Well, that right there was a shout point. That right there, somebody should have took off shouting. I don't know, y'all, man, I've got nothing else for you. I thought right there, that was going to knock somebody off your heels. That I just told you that I can see the problem with everybody else, but I can't see the problem in myself.